Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to tonight's matchup between your Brockton Boxers and the visiting Barnstable Redhawks. Brockton High School would like to take this opportunity to encourage you to display good sportsmanship to everyone involved. Please do your part by showing respect to everyone involved in today's contest. Inappropriate behavior, language, or verbal criticism of coaches, players, and officials will not be tolerated and may result in your removal from the stadium. This game is being played according to the rules of the National Federation of State High School Association. For your convenience, restrooms are located under the bleachers on the press box side. Also, please support our football boosters by visiting the snack shack located in the south end zone by the scoreboard. Tonight's game is part of the Scholastic Sports Marketing National Friday Night Lights Tour, presented by the U.S. Army. Stay tuned for some special presentations. Be sure to visit the U.S. Army station located near the main gate to enter for your chance to win $100.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
How come
nine,
I get nothing?
Ten. They're doing it now. One, two, three, four.
So you can start with, because you're going to do the play-by-play.
Yeah, I told him I'd start. Is it okay after the national anthem?
National anthem.
Jason Wuno, it's been, I remember him last year.
Okay.
G.J. Mack, How do you pronounce our starting quarterback? Winodi. Yeah. Winodi. Yes. Yes. And once in a while he did play quarterback a little bit, but Winodi. Okay.
At this time, we ask that you please rise, remove your hats, and direct your attention to the flag at midfield as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem. Fans, please turn your attention to the field. Today, Scholastic Sports Marketing, the U.S. Army, and Brockton High School would like to make a special plaque presentation. Again, joining us at midfield with Sergeant Lufkin is Principal Dr. Murray from Brockton High School. As a token of appreciation, the U.S. Army will now present a on the country this season. Scholastic Sports Marketing has provided them with a commemorative coin for the toss, as well as a coin for each team to keep as a memento for tonight's game.
Welcome everybody to Brockton High Football. This is Miles Jackson bringing you all the high school action here in Brockton, Massachusetts. Alongside with me is my play-by-play partner, Brian Madden. And Brian, we're down here again, together again down here at Rocky Marciano Stadium playing the football games on Colombo Field. So welcome back, and it's nice to see that we're starting in the fall.
Yes.
First of all, congratulations to Brockton High for their SEC championship.
Yes.
In the spring of last year, they beat Bridgewater.
Yeah.
In the championship game, and so we've got a new year. We've got a lot of new players, Brian. We got a new quarterback.
A new quarterback.
As we know, Devontae Medley moved
Barnstable
on. He graduated.
Has won the toss,
and now
and
we have number one,
Jason Winobi.
Let's hear it for our home opener.
Winobi.
Let's play some boxer football.
I'm expecting big things from Jason. He did a fine job, yes, last year. He did play a little quarterback, but he also, his main position last year was running back. But he's an outstanding athlete, good student, and I look for good things from our new quarterback this year.
Yes, so I'm excited to be back. It's been a long time since I've been up here in the booth. So, be patient, fans.
Now you know Brockton in the papers get ranked number four, but the the sports writers are not sure what type of Brockton football team they have here or that we have here. So it will be interesting to see. Again, they've lost a lot of seniors, but Coach Colombo and his staff know how to bring in the underclassmen to fill those voids.
Yes, and Barnstable is ranked 5th in the division and 18th statewide. So, but they had a scrimmage last week against.
They should have stopped by the U.S. Army Station, located here in the stadium, to meet some of America's finest.
I can't think.
And to learn more about how you can win a $100 Visa gift card, one lucky fan will be selected tonight.
So, looking forward to Brockton coming away with a victory today, hopefully.
Yeah, Brockton is in their home black jerseys, black pants, red helmets, and Barnstable's in their white helmets, white jerseys, and white pants, so you have no problem distinguishing them out there on the football field. We're getting ready to kick off this 2021 fall season of high school football, again here in Brockton, Massachusetts. Tripped up there. Let's see if we can see his name, who that
Christensen
was.
Christensen Paul.
Okay.
Wide receiver. Also, you know, special teams. And that was a good run back. Getting up to the 28-yard line, 29-yard line. 24.
Yeah, actually did. 24-yard line.
Yes.
About a 22-yard return. Man in motion, that's number 15. Powell.
Thanks, baby, number 15, Powell, Mauricio
was
Powell.
Was in motion.
Enough for a boxer.
And quarterback.
First down.
Got it right over there to him as he was in stride. And got a first down on
the
play.
Yeah, it was a very, very nice screen pass. You know, start the first play of this drive.
So first and 10. Ball looks like it's on about the 39. Pass out there again to Powell. Breaks a tackle, close to a first down.
And that was a little trickery because he was lined up on the left hash mark and threw it across the field. And I'm not sure if it was a lateral or forward pass, but it was successful.
Second down and short. Play.
Yeah, 9-yard game, second down and one for the Boxers. Powell comes out for a rest. And they give it on the swing handoff right there. And that was number 4, I believe.
Yeah, Cameron Montello.
And Cameron was in motion. And as the play developed, he was given the handoff. Going to the left side of that field.
Nice play call to go on. Go to in motion and keep it on the ground on that.
Okay, Munodi throws it short to his receiver. I think that was number 14.
Yeah, he had a little pressure there from number 74, who was
passing for number 14.
And rolled out.
Second down.
Tried to get it out there in the flat.
Yeah, you knew Munodi, you could see he felt the pressure, as you said. And I believe that's one reason why that ball went short.
Yes. Yeah, he was open over there on the side.
Catherine.
Again, these players are all getting familiar with each other. This is basically a whole new Brockton High offensive team here. Winodi in the pocket. Throws it out there, and it's incomplete. I think a little bit mix-up on the pattern that was supposed to be run.
Yeah, there was a mix-up on the play call because he was on the fly, and Winodi was expecting a button hook or a turnaround or, you know, go down and stop because he threw it to a spot, and the spot was vacant.
So third and 10 for the Boxers. 10:30 on the clock here in the first quarter. I'm Miles Jackson along with Brian Madden on our first night of high high school football. Got a decent crowd out here this evening. And it's a fake. Winodi keeps it, breaks a little tackle, and he's going to be close, but I believe he'll be a little bit short of the first down.
Yeah, he got to about the 9 yard line. I mean, 9 yards on the play.
So it's going to be a quick count.
Bring up fourth down,
go for
and
it
short.
On the fourth down. So let's see what happens. Fourth and one. Brockton is in Barnstable territory. Long snap count.
Flag on the play.
And I believe that Boxers were trying to draw the Barnstable.
Yeah, they're trying to draw him offside.
Yeah.
But he needed a good hard count, you know.
So wait a minute. That flag is not on the Boxers. It's on Barnstable. That's a big break right there, Brian. For
what?
The Boxers. I didn't see what the
result of the
called.
Flag is a Boxer first down.
How can an illegal motion be on the defense? I've never seen it in my life. Have I been gone that long, Miles?
No, you haven't. Obviously, it was more than an illegal motion. It was something on the defense. Yeah. Handoff is to the running back. I believe that was Powell. 15 it was, and right now it's early in the game, but Powell seems to be
run by
the
Powell.
Early
second
in
down.
Game.
Yes.
Second and about 5 yards to go. Pass out there in the flat, taken by number 12.
Lucas Pires.
Lucas Pires, and he's a junior.
Catch by Lucas Pires. Enough for a Boxer.
And I'll tell you,
that
play has worked. You know, later on, it might not work as easily, but right now, a quick pass out in the flat has worked for chunks of yards.
Another handoff straight ahead to Powell. And that time, it did not fool the Red Hawks of Barnstable as it's like about a 1 yard gain on the play. And right now, Box is using this quick count as they march down the field, Brian.
Yes.
And they give it off to number 10 on the end of the round, and he cuts through and gets a first down. Christian
Ball.
That was a nice
ball
run.
For
yes, it was.
Another.
Kind of round.
First down and goal for the Boxers. Let's hear it.
Okay, you heard it. First and goal for the Brockton Boxers. Unodi directing this team. Hands it off to number 4. He punches it in for a touchdown.
And that's a Boxer touchdown.
Number 4.
Cameron Montero.
Yes, Cameron Montero.
First touchdown at home for the season.
Brockton on their first offensive possession. Scores a touchdown.
Yes, and the only one that really had a chance to stop was number 6, Adam Labor. But Montero is just too strong. Punched it in.
And one thing I noticed, Brian, on the offensive possession for the Boxers, they use a lot of guys in motion.
Yes.
And it seemed like half the time that person that was in motion would somehow get the football.
Is a recipient of the ball, yes.
Recipient of the ball.
Yes.
Calling by Coach Colombo and his staff.
Excellent play call, especially your first drive, because you want to draw first blood. You know, you want to get on your drive. You want to get some points on the board.
Exactly. You want to put the visiting team on their heels.
That's it.
Put the pressure on them.
That's right.
In your home turf.
That's right.
For the Boxers score at the 7:59 mark of the first quarter. It's a 7-0 lead as the point after was good. I didn't get to see who the kicker was for the Boxers, but see more of him, hopefully, this evening.
Let's hear it for the band and cheerleaders tonight. They'll be entertaining us all night. Welcome back.
Welcome to Boxing.
kicking off is number 24. I'm gonna give you that.
Oh, Demetrius Sakara?
Sakara, he's looks like he's kicking off. And I see we passing the football to the Demetrius is a woman referee, which is nice to see.
Yes, we need more of that.
Yes, sir. Box is ready to kick off. Beautiful September evening.
Short kick. He's down.
Yeah, he put his knee on the, as he caught the football, his knee touched the turf. And in high school sports, you're down.
That's right.
Kick off by number 24, Demetrius Sequeira.
And that was number 16.
Barnstable will start at their own 22-yard line. First down. Him.
Run by number one.
By Edwards, an up for a possible first down.
Hands it off to number one again.
Tried that same play, and this time Brockton wasn't having any of that. Shut them down right there at the line of scrimmage.
And our quarterback for Barnstable is number 12, Henry Malknick, McNick.
Yeah, let me see. Where is he
at? Am I pronouncing that right? Kind of in the middle of the roster. Number 12.
Yeah, Henry McNick.
McNick, okay. Man in motion for the Red Hawks. Man goes around the corner on a running play and gets about 6 yards on the play before the boxes take him out of bounds.
Yeah, taken down by number 32, Jamal Bennett, and others.
And it looks like Barnstable's going to that quick offense, no huddle offense. And they hand it off again. And I couldn't see who the running back was. Close to a first down, but short.
Short by about 2 yards.
This will bring up fourth down and short.
That was number two.
Ball on the Red Hawk, 40-yard line.
So Barnstable goes into a huddle with fourth and one. It's a big play because Barnstable's in their own territory.
Yes, it is.
Mental error right there by the right defensive end.
65.
Yeah, just gave it. You don't want to give it to him.
Devin Miller. They were able to get him with the hard count. He stepped over the line, and that's it.
Result of the flag is a Red Hawk first down.
And then high school football, they don't have to make contact with the other player. In pros, you can, you know, go over and get back.
And Brockton just stuffs that running play.
He's going to stop. What are you doing?
For no gain.
Tackle made by number 61, Tsunami Resende.
Well, that was a tsunami, all right.
Yeah.
He came right in on him.
The tsunami wasn't going to go. Wasn't going to be denied.
That brings up second down and 10 with 6:04 on the clock here in the first quarter. 7-0 boxes. Two wideouts at the bottom of your screen. Quarterback rolled out, tried to get a pass over there to number two, but he was a little bit, that was a little bit too high for the receiver. And I think one reason that was a little bit too high because quarterback felt some pressure from the box.
He did feel some pressure. Boxers are already looking pretty good. I mean, it's less than the first quarter, but so far they've been good offensively and defensively, playing very well.
3rd and 10 for the Red Hawks. Little pitch out to the left-hand side. Running back breaks a tackle, still breaking tackle, gets over the first down marker, and he's got a first down. That looks like about a 17-yard carry on the play. Nice play by the Red Hawks.
Yes, it was a good play in the Red Hawks.
That run's good enough for a possible first down.
Tsunami was in on the tackle as well as Devin Miller.
Another handoff. And they finally take him down, but after about a 5 or 6 yard gain on the carry, that was number one. Aiden Edwards on the carry.
Barnstable seems like they're going to be concentrating on staying on the ground for the most part.
Little pitch out to the left-hand side. And a first down. I believe that was number 30.
Run by number 34, Jordan.
34.
Now for a Barnstable. First down.
Tough runner, Eugene Jordan. Bring 1st and 10 with 4:52 on the clock. Hand off to the right-hand side. He stopped immediately. Red Raiders marching down the field. Pass out there to the flat. And the boxers are on it. Maybe a gain of one, maybe if not, no gain at all.
Malachi Johnson came in strong. And he was held low. The receiver was held low, and he came in high and took him down hard.
Yeah, he finished off that play very nicely. Right up the middle. There's a hole in Barnstable's running back. It's
wait
a
for
big
the
gain. That's number 34 again.
And Darren Castor stopped that play because he might have still been running if Darren didn't grab him around the call and bring him down.
Yep, and I believe that's
the result of the run is a
first down.
First down.
Barnstable
driving
down the field with basically running plays.
So they're going to be basically on the ground with some pass plays in between. But that's their strength.
Timeout boxers
with 3:34 here in this first quarter. And we talked about how good the boxers' offense looked, passing and running, and now we've got our first look at this Barnstable team, and they got a pretty good running attack.
Yeah, they're strong on the ground, and they're making some noise.
And I think that's a good timeout
by
Brockton.
Yeah, because they want to be grouped. They want to get focused, you know, concentrate, and they would need a stop. It's 1st and 10, but if they could stop them and hold them to an attempt maybe at a field goal, that'd be a victory.
Okay.
On this drive.
Yep. Barnstable has their offense spread out for the first time. They got two wideouts on each side of the, and they shift and come in. And basically they've been playing a tight offense all along, so that was a cover. Handoff. Straight ahead. Touchdown.
The result of the play is a Barnstable touchdown.
Nice play by the Barnstable Redhawks as they use a page out of Brockton's playbook with a man in motion, receive the football.
Yeah, Edwards, I mean, he went around that corner and had a nice little hole when he was helped significantly by number two, if you can find him on this sheet. Gibson Gilmon, captain, who made a nice block.
Kick is up, and the kick is good.
Extra point is good, and we have a tie game.
Well, let's give the Red Raiders offensive line a...
Red Hawks.
It's going to be Red Hawks, not the Red Raiders.
Yes.
Who are the Red Raiders?
Not Barnstable.
Yeah. Red Hawks. But the Red Hawks, their offensive line did a nice job. Because
they
basically
did.
It was a running attack all the way down the field, and they made some holes
for
their running backs.
Yes, they did. And the running backs, you know, found those holes and made their proper cuts and just picked up, you know, 4 yards here, 6 yards there, 8 yards here and there. So it was a nice drive.
You got 3:28 left in this first quarter. So Brockton on their offensive possession, used some time on the clock. Barnstable, same thing. Took some time off the clock, and we've got 3:28 left in this first quarter. And there's a kick taken at a 25. Excuse me, at the 15. And taken down at about the 32, 33 yard line.
Presented by Malachi Johnson, number 20.
Yeah, Malachi Johnson, nice run back. Before he managed to number 10. But Brockton again with good field position at the 32.
Spread out. Pass out there to his man in motion. And he comes out limping. That's not a good sign. That's Christian Paul. And he's been one of the main guys out there. He comes out limping. Maybe a slightly twisted ankle.
Yes. It looked like there was a flag on the play, but they picked it up.
Second down, about 5 yards to go. And his whistles.
Flag
on
the
play.
There's
a flag on the play.
Motion.
Yeah, most likely. Motion penalty.
Here's the white cap. Oh, he's in the huddle. Should be coming out. Yep. Here he is.
Motion, so that'll be a 5 yard penalty.
You too.
Okay, second down at about 11. Brockton. Again, offense is spread out. 2 men in motion. Long count. And they hand it off. Flag on the play.
Another flag on the play.
Yeah, it was holding.
And usually if the referee throws a flag, it's most likely the offense back there.
Yeah, from behind the play.
Right now, the boxes are going backwards.
Yes, they're going in the wrong direction.
On this particular series of downs here. And that's a 10-yarder.
They're holding. I don't want to call the wrong number.
Call is holding on boxers. Brings up second and long.
About 2nd and 22 yards to go, approximately 22, 23 yards for first. The ball has to get up by the 42.
Yeah, they'll need it all on one play.
Nope.
Try and get like half.
throws it out there and just out of his reach.
Pass intended Lucas for number Pyres. 12, Lucas Pyres, brings up third and long.
If he could have waited
if another
held
second. It for one more beat.
Yes.
But had he held it for that one more beat, the defender was right there. It could have very well be going in the other direction.
Yeah.
So it had been perfectly placed to get it over the two defenders.
A third and long for the Boxers.
Here you go. Here you go.
Offside, Barnstable.
Some free yards there.
Yep.
Eat into that 24 yards.
So that's a 5-yard penalty.
Third and 19.
As you can see, Box's offense spread wide on both sides. One man in the backfield. Stood tall in the pocket.
Incomplete pass brings
downfield,
up fourth
but
down.
His receiver just could not hold on to it. Tough break right there.
Yeah, because that was an excellent throw.
That was.
And it would have been for a first down as well.
So the Boxers will have to punt on their second series.
Number 61 is back to punt. Tsunami was ending.
There's a snap, low snap, but he gets it off. Short kick, but
nice.
A Brockton bounce.
Redhawks will start from their own 42-yard line, first down.
Nice to see our Brockton documentary producer and director, Newby Ritola of Newby Productions, has stepped in the booth for us.
Yes, and I want to mention Newby's Media Expo,
yeah.
Newby Productions. It is September 25th, 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. at the Brockton Main Library. Music, free food, and drinks. Sponsored by Brockton Cultural Council. Just checking in, Northeastern Savings Bank, George DeSantos, Total Mortgage. Visit us at www.noubeproductions.com.
There you go. And there's a lot of TV, I believe TV and radio personalities will be at that expo.
Yes, and if you're interested in doing anything with media, go to this free event.
Yeah.
Because you will learn so much. Newbie is a. That's right. Who? Oh, Film Union's gonna be there. And Newbie is an Emmy Award winning documentary.
From Brockton High School.
From Brockton High School.
AKA Bridgewater State University.
Yes.
So we got third down and about 5 yards to go.
One minute left in the quarter, one minute. Actually, for
Brockton's defense, with 57 seconds to go, big third down for Brockton's defense. Little pitch out to the right. And it's going to be close. It's going to be close.
You got to wait for the spot.
Yep, it depends on where the referees put the spot.
And I'll tell you, Barnstable's offensive line, he's doing a great job opening up holes. I mean, you got Pat O'Neill leading the charge, as well as number 10, Colin Fay, just making a nice little lane for running back.
Yeah, and now that you mention it, Brian, I'm looking at the offensive line, and besides being a bunch of pretty big guys, a lot of them look like they're in pretty good shape.
Coming out for a measurement.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, because a lot of times the offensive line is bigger guys, and these guys are really pretty thin.
Yeah. I mean, you can tell they're very toned. You don't have a lot of roly-polies on their offensive line. Again, at Newbie's Media Expo, I believe he's got, her name's gone blank, but for Channel 7 News, a sports reporter there, you see her. Young sister.
Chelsea McDonald
will be there. There you go.
Yeah, her alone is a draw.
It's a draw. But I know in 2019, Newbie had this expo, and it's excellent.
This will bring us fourth down and one.
I've attended them in the past, and it's an informational explosion.
Yeah, and a number of those participants, as far as kids out there, they've gone on to bigger media-type dreams that they had because of Newbie's expo.
That's right. And Newbie, who worked in television production with Brockton High, just went on to bigger and better things.
Time to get loud. Here we go.
27 seconds on the clock. Fourth down and about 2 yards to go. Ball's handed off. And I think he
made the first down.
Yep. A lot of activity. It's a first down. Nice job by Frost.
And that's enough for a boxer. First down.
Give that running back just enough Redhawks space
first
in there.
Down.
To for them to continue
this drive,
yes.
And I'll tell you, they are fired up on the other side of the field.
End-around handoff.
Nice end-around, number one.
And he's taking it almost to another first down, a little short. But that was a nice play that developed for Barnstable's offense.
Yeah. Well, that's the end of the first quarter.
Yep, end of the first quarter, 7-7 lead. Game early on in this fall season.
And it's a beautiful night. Nice, cool, comfortable. It's a football night.
Yeah, and I mean the wind doesn't play any factor.
No.
Very calm.
Yeah. Comfortable 66 degrees here at our Colombo Stadium. Son Peter over in El Segundo, California. Hello from your dad, as well as his grandson.
Okay, we'll switch sides. Now Barnstable will head in the opposite direction. I believe that's north or east.
Yes, they're headed north.
Headed north. Little pitch out, little razzle dazzle.
Oh, flea flicker.
Got a man wide open. He's wide open. And it totally fooled the Brockton Boxers defense. Touchdown, Barnstable Redhawks.
And number two.
And the flea flicker totally caught Brockton's defense off guard.
Yeah, the defense, you know, missed the ball on that one.
Yeah, somebody blew the coverage.
Blew the coverage and was not down there.
So Barnstable comes up at 11:50, puts 6 points on the board. Here's the point after. Ball is down, kick is up, kick is good.
Extra point is good as Barnstable takes a 14-7 lead.
With a flea flicker, Brian.
Yeah, that was a nice trick play. I mean, it was an end-around pass. It touched four players' hands. The quarterback, then the end-around, handed off, and then back to the quarterback. And Gilman was wide open down there, just sitting and waiting at the 6-yard line.
Now, this is where the coaches, boxes become very important. They have to calm their guys down. Don't worry about it. We're only in the beginning of the second quarter.
That's right.
So don't worry about it. Just be aware. Do your job and your take your assignments and stick with your assignment.
That's right, because they're down by seven. That's that one play is just the equivalent of driving down and scoring a touchdown. It's one touchdown. They just did it in two plays. Well, one play after the end of the quarter.
Nice kick. Taken at the 10. Breaks some tackles. Jukes. Finally gets in inside the 45-yard line. A nice run back.
Big run by number 20, Malachi Johnson. We had a flag
Malachi
on the play.
Malachi Johnson with the nice run return.
Yeah, it was an excellent return. I mean, he brought it all the way up to the 42-yard line.
Yeah, you're talking a 32-yard return.
43. So what's the flag for? Based on body language, it appears to be against the Brockton boxes. Coach Colombo is not happy. He backed him up.
That's a 10-yard penalty.
Still didn't see what the call was.
I didn't quite recognize what the call was by the referee.
But based on the movement of the ball, maybe unsportsmanlike conduct, late hit, something, I don't know. Because we're blocked by the boxer's sideline.
Sideline, yes. Winodi hands it off.
Oh, ball's on the ground.
Fumble.
Fumble on the play.
Barnstable has
football.
Barnstable
so
football.
So there was a mix-up on a handoff, and yes. Winodi somehow lost the football. So two unfortunate plays that just happened to the boxes. First a flea flick and now the turnover.
But this is where you got to show your grit.
This is where you got to show your grit.
And you got to stop, make it a three and out and get the ball back. You'll be backed up. But
Barnstable
you
got to
stop them from scoring. You don't want to go down by
14 points. First down.
In the first half.
So right now Barnstable has the momentum with their offense coming back on the field in boxer territory. Ball is about the 29-yard line of Brockton. Little fake handoff. Quarterback rolls out, has a receiver, caught, taken out of bounds. I could not see who that receiver was.
Well, I know that tackler was Tsunami. Tsunami brings the noise.
Handoff. Goes to the outside. Ooh, nice jarring tackle by the cornerback over there, number 6.
Tackle by number 6, Malachi McLean.
Textbook tackle right there because he was a little bit smaller than the ball carrier, and he took him down nicely.
Nice. Tsunami.
That did not fool Tsunami.
Racked up by Tsunami Resende.
We gotta find the nickname for this kid.
Like Tsunami.
Well, underwater earthquake.
Yeah. Wow. Right there in the middle where all the action is. Second down, about 12 yards to go, a 2-yard loss on the play. Quarterback keeps it. And he gets a few yards on the play. That was Macnick.
Who do you think was in on the tackle?
Tsunami.
Of course. As well as a few others, but
third down.
Tsunami stepping up. Big time.
Quarterback for Barnstable, Henry Mackney. He's a junior. Leading this Red Hawk team. 9:53 on the clock here in the second quarter. And Barnstable is going to call a timeout because the coach over there, he is livid. He did not like something that his team wasn't doing. So it'll be a timeout. 9:48 on the clock again. Barnstable up 14-7 over Brockton in the first half.
To be able to make a field goal from that range.
Yeah, it's a big third down for the Boxers.
It's a big third down.
For their defense. What they must do, they must not let the Barnstable team get down there where it's fourth and one, fourth and two.
Yeah, exactly.
They really need to hold them here. Handoff, breaks a tackle, first down, still going on his feet, and he looks like he's about at the 5 or 6 yard line. Great running.
It was a good run by number 34. Found a hole and just...
There is a flag on the play.
Oh.
Created a flag on the play, let's see what it is. That's gonna be a big mistake if it's Barnstable, but we'll have to wait and see. And it'll be a mistake for Brockton. Let's see, it looks like Barnstable's heading the opposite way, so break there for Brockton is.
Yes.
Barnstable made a mistake, caught with a flag, so I guess it'll be third and about 13.
Yeah, a lot.
Third and 13, so. Boxes here at another test.
Flag is on the Red Hawks. That'll make it third down and 13.
So here we go.
Good time to get loud.
Roll out. He's looking. Fires.
Nice.
But it's going to be about 5 yards short at least. So it's going
to be interesting to see what the fourth down.
Decide what to do on this fourth down situation. I mean, what can you do? You go.
Yeah. It's,
unless you got a good kicker.
Well, it's fourth and six. So that's it's a pretty good amount of yards.
It is.
Now, they have made some plays where they've gotten 6, 8, 7, 10 yards.
Well, I was getting ready to say that. A number of their running plays have big chunks of
big chunks of yards.
And they want to talk about it.
Yeah.
You know?
And this will give Brockton's chance for their coaches to
talk
to.
Let's take a quick attendance.
Their young defensive team.
If you're in the Red House, let's hear some noise. If you're in Azure, let's hear it. If you're in the Yellow House.
Mr. Jackson, what house were you in?
And if you're in the
greenhouse.
Right, Yellow House has it. Big fourth down. Let's hear it, crowd.
Really? Come on, crowd. Where you at?
Okay, here we go, folks. Fourth and about six, at least.
Oh, no. He's kicking.
Seven. Oh, they're going to kick it. Low snap. But he gets it up. Kick is...
Good.
The field goal is good.
So Barnstable has a kicker.
They have a kicker.
And
great job by the
17-7.
Yeah, that was a low snap.
That was a low snap.
In the ground, he was able to keep his composure, get that ball up for the kicker to put it through the uprights. So 8:48, a 17-7 Barnstable lead here in the second quarter.
Once again, well, big know, thanks to our
really has to do
band, our
right
cheerleaders,
now,
our color
is,
guards, our majorettes,
make a drive
our halftime dancers.
Score, cut
we
it
are
down
so
to
glad
three,
to see you back.
Go to the locker room, down by three. It's a new game at the third quarter.
But take looking at the Barnstable offense, I think one thing now is Brockton's going to have to use up some of that clock, keep this Barnstable offense off the field, because right now they have a nasty running attack.
Well, Brockton has the ability to mix it up with running plays, and because they were running the ball effectively in the first quarter, that first drive, they drove down, mixed it up with runs and pass plays, but they want to use up that clock. So I'd keep it on the ground, do some screens, move the chains on a regular basis.
All taken at the 10. Breaks a tackle. Comes up the middle and finally taken down there. Another exciting run by number 13. 13.
And I think if he would have bounced outside,
yes.
And that was Michael Victor.
I thought he was going to go outside.
I thought
use
he was
going
to go outside, yeah. Because if he would have went outside and went to the other sideline, he might have been able to go to the house. But once he cut inside,
it gave the other team the opportunity to close in on him.
He ran into traffic. Yeah.
Boxes right at their own 34-yard line. Today, no huddle offense.
Ashbury Sharon. He made a good tackle there.
Second and five. Quarterback keeper gets the first down and more. Breaks the tackle. And finally steps out of bounds at about the inside Barnstable territory.
For a boxer, first down.
Looks like they'll place it at the Barnstable 44-yard line. Nice run by the quarterback.
Nice run by the quarterback, and it appeared like he slipped when he got to the sideline.
Straight up the middle. That's Powell. Breaks a tackle.
Hold on to the ball.
He's finally taken down. And there's still whistles.
Yeah.
Why don't you throw a flag, I mean?
Yeah, because I don't know what's going on.
Yeah.
I don't know if it seems like they're a little chippy out there. But you don't want, he's telling the Brockton boxers to move back.
Yeah.
They're on the gray. They need to move back to the green.
A second down and about 3 yards to go.
Unfortunately, they just got a warning on that one.
Brockton gives it to number four, and he gets deep into Barnstable territory on a nice carry. That was number four.
Cameron Montero for another boxer. First
yes.
down.
First and 10. And it's a flag.
Flag on the play.
He knows it too.
He knows it, yeah.
Boston. Number 75.
This is a great drive they're doing right here. They're really using up not very much of the clock. So it really wouldn't be bad for them to just let their clock tick down a little bit.
6:48 ticking. Noti. Quarterback. They hand it off to number 21. He breaks a tackle.
Nice run by 21.
Barnes. Saquon Barnes, number 21.
We haven't called his name much this game, but he's doing what he got to do, Saquon.
Well, they're rotating their backs. Quarterback keeps it. Brody has an opening. Gets into inside the 5-yard line and a nice job running with that football.
Brody down blockers. To the 4-yard line. It's first and goal for Boxers.
Number 14, Valen Gapson.
So 5:57 and running here in the second quarter. Boxers trying to put 6 points on the board here. And timeout Barnstable.
Timeout Barnstable.
And that's a good timeout by Barnstable, trying to slow down the momentum of the Boxers.
So it's nice to see, Brian, that the Boxer offense calmed down a little bit after that. Disaster down there on the because
the fumble
resulted in 6 points.
Yeah, the fumble resulted in three, the trick play with an end around and the flea flicker, that resulted in seven. The Bucks are just a couple plays away or one play away from cutting that lead to three.
All they have to do is execute
and hold on to the ball.
Hold on to the football.
And keep doing what they're doing.
I think if the Boxers can continue this pass run, but a lot of running on this particular series in the second half, hopefully they can wear down that Barnstable defense a little bit.
Yes. Because in high school football, many of the kids play dual roles. They play lineman and linebacker, lineman and defense.
Yeah. Winodi.
Touchdown.
Winodi.
No flags.
Touchdown.
Boxers get on the scoreboard. That was a very important score, Brian.
And that was quick. Because it was eight minutes of change. And it's 5 minutes of change. So they scored in 3 minutes.
And it was mostly running plays.
Running plays. And huge chunks of yards. 10-yard running plays. 8 yards. 7. So. Great job by the Brockton Boxers.
Here's the point after. Kick is up. Kick is good.
Yeah, that was good. Extra point is now 17-14.
I was going to say the exact same words. They bounced back.
Yes.
Yes.
And that was good for the psyche.
Yes.
For the kids.
Yes. Yes. Because it reaffirms their confidence. Not that they lack confidence, but,
right.
After giving up a quick 10 points.
Yes.
And to come back and drive and score in 3 minutes shows their intestinal fortitude.
Nice job by Coach Colombo and his coaches. He's the kickoff. He's the kicker.
He had to make that stop.
Yeah. But so anytime your kicker has to make the tackle.
Yeah, he's gone too far.
Yeah, he's gone too far. The ball carrier has gone too far. So here are the Red Hawks.
With a lot of time.
5:35 on the clock here in the second quarter.
Time on Brockton.
Brockton calls a timeout. And the coaches saw something they didn't like.
Exactly.
You can see the players are even looking at each other and pointing like, okay, well.
So they may have defense may have had the wrong defensive scheme, or the offense, offense was lined up in a way that
they
picked up a bunch of yards last time if they, and they saw it.
Pitch out to the man in motion. That's number two. He cuts back up. Gets about 4 yards on the carry.
Tackle by number 20, Malachi Johnson. Brings up second down.
Malachi stopped that play at about 4 yards.
That was Gibson on the carry. Gibson Guman, handoff. And tackled just before he got the first down. Tackled nicely. And number six gets up hobbling. And let's hope that he's okay.
He'll be all right.
He's a pretty good cornerback.
Yeah. Malachi McClain. Oh,
he's in pain.
He's in pain.
Third and short for Barnstable. Man in motion. Ah, there was some movement there. Number one, Edwards.
Back
moved
him
a little bit early. That's a big play for the Barnstable,
yes.
But big mistake for the Barnstable team. So instead of being three and short, it's now three and long.
Yeah, so. Be third and should be six.
Flag on Barnstable makes it third down and seven.
Third seven. Let's see if the boxes can hold.
Nice stop.
Nice. And somebody gave him a nice bear hug. Of course, who was it? But
Tsunami.
Did a nice job, a big bear hug. And that will force Barnstable to kick, maybe. With 4:14, and the clock is running.
Tsunami needs to get a copy of this game right here.
Yeah, this first half has been nothing but a tsunami.
Yes.
For that front line there.
He's really stepped up. When
back to receivers number 20, Malachi
Red
Johnson.
Hawks have made up momentum going.
Yeah,
he's gotten there. He's made numerous tackles.
Yeah, he's definitely settled down. That defensive line for the boxes. And it'll be a punting situation. Whoa! Dangerous.
Yes.
He should have just let that go.
He was fortunate
to
hold
on
to that.
Yeah.
Because that the ball got there just a second before the defender.
Set of the second.
Make sure to stop by the U.S. Army
that
Station
was Malachi
located
Johnson
here in the stadium.
With the brave play. Out in the flat and nowhere to go. Barnstable's defense was right there. Maybe gain one or two.
That was good defense.
3:13 on the clock and running. Here in the second quarter, this is BCA Sports bringing you the home opener of our Brockton Boxers. Quarterback keeper.
Oh,
there he goes.
Oh, he's gone. He's gone.
He's gone.
He's gone. He's gone.
30, 20, 10. He brings it to the house.
Touchdown.
Oh, he's
on
the ball. That was nice.
Unoni.
Yeah. That was a nice spinner. He spun the ball on the turf. On the turf.
Right. That was just a great play, great run by our quarterback.
And just like that, the Barnstable take the lead.
Followed his blocks, and then it was rest speed.
And once he got around the corner and hit that hole, there was only one play, one defender to beat, and he wasn't going to catch
him.
Nice run, and he's the holder.
Here's the extra point. Kick is up. Kick is good.
Extra point is good.
So the Boxers.
Boxers take the lead. 21-17.
21-17, Brian.
In 20 seconds. That was nice.
Very pretty.
Yes.
So we know our new quarterback, Winodi, has the ability to break that quarterback keeper.
And he has the speed to take it all the way to the house. So well done by the Boxers.
Yeah.
Boxers. After giving up a trick play touchdown, which took them up on, gave them a 7-point lead. And then they had the fumble by, who's that guy? Winodi. And they scored a field goal on that, up by 10. And they just wiped that out real quick.
This should give the Brockton defense a little bit more momentum, knowing that their offense has come through for them. Now they get to get their chance to shine again. Short kick, taken at the 20. Goes around left-hand side.
Oh.
And it's hit right in his tracks. Stopped right in his tracks. He did not go down, but he stopped right in his tracks and went out of bounds.
Demetrius Sequoia. Oh, my goodness.
Been hearing that name quite a bit today.
What a hit. Stood him up. Stood him up straight. Ready for some football.
Why we got a chance. How'd you like that football game last night?
I watched most of it before I fell asleep.
Yeah. It was quite exciting.
But it was good.
Yeah.
That Brady Brown.
Possible start from there.
Culmination.
43
nasty.
Outline. First
it's
down.
Be nasty.
So Red Hawks with the football.
Ooh.
Quarterback drops back. Feels the pressure and
throws it away. Yeah.
Smartly.
And that was great defense by numbers 58 and 24 and 20.
And
Malachi Johnson. Yep.
And the pressure by Tsunami and number 71.
Yes.
Aaron Russell. That lineman did a good job getting through. Put the pressure on the quarterback. He wanted to stay in the pocket, but there's no way.
He wanted to stay in the pocket and wait for his receivers to find a little space, get a little open.
Handoff. Trying to go to the outside. He's looking for opening. Finds a small opening. Gain of maybe 2 or 3 yards on the carry.
And that was great defense by the Brockton Boxers, because as he ran down the line trying to get around the corner, the Brockton Boxers were with him stride for stride and shut down that lane, keeping him to just a 2 or 3 yard gain.
Less than 2 minutes to go in this second quarter, flag on the play.
Ooh.
Breaks a tackle. Still going.
Flag on the play.
And I believe it's on Barnstable.
Yeah, let's hope so. With clock stops at 1 minute and 51 seconds.
Folks, make sure to stick around for the halftime show.
It's on Barnstable. I'm not sure what that penalty is. Where he's putting his hands out in front of his chest. So the ball is placed back on the 40. It was called the 42.
Maybe a legal shift?
Yeah, possible. Third down. Whistles again.
Time out, Boxers.
Coach just didn't like something.
Yeah, just before the ball was snapped.
So we've got a timeout with 1 minute 48 seconds in this second quarter. Has been exciting first half for the Boxers and for Barnstable. They've had something to cheer about, but so far early on in this season, the Boxers have shown their role. Trying to find a word. Early on, to not panic and get back control of this football game.
Exactly. Miles, I must say, it's good to be back in the booth with you.
I missed you, bro.
I missed you, too.
It's always nice to get one of the originals back in here.
All this missing is Mr. Zimbo.
Yeah.
Peter, but Peter's doing big things with boxing.
Yes, he is. Little short passes.
Ooh.
Wow. Taken down. Incomplete pass.
And the referees are letting them play.
Yeah. I'll tell you, the Barnstable dodged the bullet right there because it went off the receiver's hand. And that ball was in the air for a little bit.
Yeah.
Boswell's lucky that one of those defensive backs or linebackers happened to be right in that area and grab that. That would have been a punch in the stomach. So there's a penalty on the Boxers. Ooh, a 10-yarder. 15-yarder, so that's what's unsportsmanlike conduct.
Yeah, it might have been that extracurricular.
Yes, when the whistle's blowing and he's still throwing them down. Because we even made a comment on it. And Coach Colombo goes out there and speaking to the referee, asking him what's going on. But I didn't see a flag or anything.
I never saw a flag, but I saw the tackle, you know, threw him down.
And Coach Colombo does deserve an explanation. Where's the flag? I don't blame him for being a little upset on that one.
Delay a game.
Wow. Okay, first and 10. The Barnstable has the ball in box territory.
The flag is a Red Hawk first down.
All right, here we go. Minute 40 seconds go. Let's get a couple stops.
Well, that did not fool the Boxer defensive line. Is Tsunami and company. Comes in there and just stops all the...
I love when that kid makes a tackle because he gets up and he goes all Adamic and Sue.
Yes, Tsunami.
Yes. It is. Tsunami. Get a copy of this game. More to come, hopefully.
Quarterback drops back. Long pass. Out of bounds. So that'll bring up third down.
Third down and 13.
Just over a minute to play in the first half.
Man in motion, little pitch out. And he is taken down quickly. Maybe a loss of a yard, or just barely back to the line of scrimmage.
Tackle,
nice job by Brockton's
down.
Defense.
defense by Brockton. Every time Barnstable tries to bounce it outside, Brockton right there to meet him right at the line of scrimmage or shortly after.
So fourth down with 23 seconds to go. Barnstable will not give it back to the boxers. They'll just try to run the clock out here. High snap, but taken. And the running back gets back to the original line of scrimmage, maybe a couple yards after that, but, and the clock is stopped at 10 seconds here in the second.
Stop the clock at 10 seconds.
Yep. So the boxers will put their offense back on the field for one more play before this second quarter ends. This is BCA Sports. I'm Miles Jackson along with Brian Madden bringing you this first half exciting action here at Rocky Marciano Stadium. One more play before this first half ends. Quarterback's in the pocket, throws it out there, but it was behind the receiver. Still 6 seconds left, so they'll get one more chance. With the football. Again, the score, Brock's is set 21, Barnstable 17. A very exciting first half.
Yeah, and Coach Colombo's not kneeling, just running out the clock. He's trying to see what they can do, see what happens. You never know.
Well, he's finding out early on. He's got some players out there that can make big plays. He's finding out early in the season, very first game, that he's possibly got some breakaway type
playmakers.
Yeah,
yeah, some playmakers.
Playmakers, yeah.
There you go. High-risk injury.
Yeah,
high-risk injury. 6 seconds. You're leading by four.
So here we are at halftime. Your Boxers.
We're at halftime.
Home opener.
Boxers 21.
Barnstable 17.
Barnstable 17. We'll be back with second half action in a moment.
The winning lottery or ticket from the boosters is a red ticket, 872288. Last four are 2288. If you have that lucky red ticket, come to the press booth. The Brockton High School Marching Band is pleased to present their 2021 show, The Music of Motown, featuring the groundbreaking music of The Temptations, The Supremes, Stevie Wonder, The Jackson 5, and more. After a long year off, they are thrilled to finally take the field again and bring music to the City of Champions. Now, please welcome, under the direction of drum major Kyle Gildner, the Brockton High School Marching Band. Thank you. That. Let's hear it again for the marching band. The Brockton High Marching Band is under the direction of Andrew Benduccio, Assistant Director Susan Goodwin-May, Percussion Instructors Michael Montega, Jonathan Monroe, Daniel Alves, and Rule St. Louis. Color Guard instructors Rebecca Desmond and Jennifer McKenzie. Majorette instructor Judy Noon. And halftime dance team instructors Caitlin Fitzgerald and Lindsay Gomes.
Welcome back, everybody, to Brockton High Basketball. I'm Miles Jackson, along with my color man, Brian Madden. And we're happy to join you down here at Rocky Marciano Stadium, playing on Colombo Field. And Brian, we've had a great first half starting out this 2021 fall season for high school football.
Yes, a very exciting first half. And actually, while we're at intermission, we were downstairs and the white cap, the referee for the game, was talking about how fantastic a game it is and how exciting it is. Two great teams playing against each other in a close game. He said he loves it, having football back.
Yeah, he did sound excited about having high school football back with the fans in the stands, the band, etc. So Brockton right now, they will be kicking off the football, and Barnstable will receive the football here in the second half. Action, and it's a short kick taken at the 27 and taken down quickly at the 26. Nice tackle there.
Number 20.
By number 20.
And great job by Malachi Johnson.
And you've heard that name. Malachi Johnson.
Yeah, we've called his name numerous times throughout the game.
And Malachi, he's a sophomore, Brian.
So we'll see him for years to come, hopefully.
And whistles blow. And let's see what's going on. And they're going to give a five. Too many men on the field. Too many men on the field by the defense. So it'll be second, first down and five. Tight formation by Barnstable. The tsunami trips up the running back, and his teammates
58
take him down.
And Xavier Laguerre.
So about second down and six. Loss of one on the play. A little end around, but taken down quickly and efficiently. And that Brockton player is down. And he's the one who made the tackle. I'm not sure who that is.
Let's see if I can see.
So we've got a timeout, official timeout.
Or he might have a cramp in his leg or something.
11:24 left on the clock here in the third quarter, early on here in the third quarter.
All right, he's taking a look at the knee, the right knee.
So hopefully it's something minor. As Brian said, maybe a cramp.
Number seven.
Send him some boxer love.
But he's favoring that right leg. That's Nathan Baptista for the Boxers. And he's a junior. And he'll come out. So it's going to be third down at about 7 yards to go for a first. Ball is just inside the 30. Little pitch out. And the running back gets good yardage, but just falls short of the first down. So it'll be fourth and short.
And another good stop by Boxers.
Yes.
Yeah.
Let's see what Barnstable does.
Fourth down and short. Good time to be loud.
Okay, let's see if the Boxers can stay on sides. One time, Barnstable caught him off guard, but straight up the middle.
Nice stop.
Nice stop, but I believe he got the first down. And he just barely got the first down.
Yeah.
So Barnstable will continue. 10:43 here in the third quarter. No huddle offense for Barnstable at the time. Hand it off again, straight through the middle, big hole, and he's tripped up. Just before he looked like he was going to break it away, but he's tripped up nicely.
Number 20.
And that's going to be a first down. Barnstable with their no-huddle offense.
Man, we've called his name a lot, Malachi Johnson.
Again, handoff, left-hand side. Running back cuts back inside, gets about 3 yards on the carry. So we got second down at about 7. A little pitch out to the left-hand side, cut through, has an opening, still on his feet, gets a first down and more. He was determined. I believe that was 34. Eugene Jordan.
Jordan.
Tough running for Barnstable. First and 10, inside Boxer territory. Red Hawks, man in motion. Little counter, straight up the middle. And
we still haven't found our winner of the 50-50 raffle.
About a gain of 3 yards on the carry.
Red ticket, 2288. 2288.
All right, this is a good time for a stop.
Barnstable starting this third quarter, marching down the field. They're now in Brockton territory.
Gives the number counter. One.
Another hole opening, almost up. He busted it. That's Aiden Edwards with the nice run for a first down. Almost broke it open.
Yeah.
But taken down at the very end there.
Shoestring tackle by Kobe Mybrek.
Counter again. And this time, Edwards is stopped at the line of scrimmage. And the Red Raiders with this hurry-up offense is trying to throw the Brockton defense off guard.
Uh-oh.
Oh! There's a hole. There's a touchdown. Big hole. He broke a couple of tackles. I believe that was Jordan.
That was 34.
With the nice run. That was a 25-yard scamper right up the middle.
Yeah, Eugene Jordan.
I tell you, Barnstable's doing a great job with their counter plays because it just freezes the Brockton defense right there, the linebackers, just for a moment, just enough. And the offensive line is giving their running backs just enough space to break through. Kick is up for the extra point, and the kick is good.
Extra point is good.
And they're mixing it up nice.
24-21.
So the Red Hawks take a three-point lead, 24-21, early on in this third quarter, 8:16 on the clock. And a nice job by the Barnstable team marching down the field on their first possession. and here in the third quarter to get 7 points on the board.
How can it be 24-21? Didn't somebody miss a field goal? I mean, extra point?
Yes.
There was an extra point that was missed.
There was an extra point missed. That was by Brockton, wasn't it? They did a two-pointer?
I didn't see any two-point conversions. Huh? Every kick was made? Okay. Clarification.
Thank you very much. We got
every kick's been made. He ought to know. He's the scorekeeper.
AKA announcer. Kick is deep. Wow. Taken at the two.
Ooh.
And taken down at about the 18-yard line. So the Boxer offense will come back on the field. That was a nice kickoff.
Yeah.
Because that took the kick return all the way back to about the 1 or 2 yard line, and he did a nice job holding on to it, then getting back straight ahead.
Yeah, and Asbury Sharon, he stopped him right there in his tracks.
Boxes in the shotgun. Hands it off straight ahead. For maybe a yard. As
short yardage on the play.
Barnstable was ready. And the Boxes have their own version of the hurry up offense. Unodi back there, quarterback. You've got three wide receivers right there in front of your screen. Quick toss. That was to number 12, Lucas Perez. For a short gain. But now it's third down and third down about 4 or 5 yards to go, Brian.
Yeah, about 4 yards, yeah. That's a nice little pickup of 5 yards. Throwing it out in the flat.
Offense is spread out. A little fake handoff. And it did not fool Barnstable.
No, yeah, nowhere to go.
Nowhere to go.
Number 57 right there in position. Shut that down.
And the coaches for Barnstable were jumping up and down after that nice stop. So it'll be a punting situation for the Boxers.
And that was Kyle Hicks.
6:26 on the clock and running here in the third quarter.
And they have no one back to receive.
Interesting.
That's weird. Oh, they were trying to block it.
Short punt, but it takes a box of bounce into Barnstable territory and still rolling.
Let it roll.
Inside the 40-yard line. Nice punt.
Nice punt.
By Brockton's punter. Barnstable's offense is back on the field, and they're ready to call the play. They're not really fooling around with this no-huddle offense. They think that they can they got a little advantage with Brockton's defense.
Yeah, and, you know, Brockton needs to just turn it up like they did last quarter.
Yes.
Because their defense turned up in the second quarter.
Taken down, but not after a 5-yard gain on the play.
Looks like they're going hurry up again.
Yeah. Ooh, nice. Nice tackle there.
Yes. backed them up just a little bit. Loss of about 1.5.
Yeah, that was trying to see his number here. Couldn't get the number, but he did a nice play. It's like he's outside linebacker over there on the right. Going to the opposite end. Open space over there. Gets around the corner and finally taken down. That was good blocking by...
Yeah, excellent blocking.
Yes, because he had nobody. When he turned the corner, there really was nobody there.
Yeah, and Malachi Johnson stopped the touchdown because he was on his way.
And you can see Barnstable with their very tight, tight offense set up. Counter. Taken down, but not after about a 5-yard gain on the carry.
And that was a little delay handoff. And then, you know, delayed play. But Boston shut it down.
4:31 and counting here in the third quarter. Barnstable with a 3-point lead. Handoff. Got an opening. There he goes.
He's gone.
He's gone, folks. 5, touchdown. That's number 12, but we have a flag on the play. That was a quarterback with the football.
No, that was actually Gibson Gamon.
And they're going to bring that back. Fortunately for the Boxers, they will bring that back, a penalty on Barnstable. Possibly holding.
Let's see, where's the white cap? White cap is holding.
And that's what it is, holding on Barnstable. So a break there for the Boxers.
Holding on Barnstable. That'll bring back the touchdown.
Oh, that one had to hurt for the Red Hawks.
Yeah, because that would have...
That really put the pressure on the Boxers.
It really would have.
Because right now, Barnstable's got a 3-point lead, 24-21.
They need 2 good stops right here.
Yep, second down and about 16 yards to go for first. They need to get inside the 30 for a first down.
Barnstable looks confused right now.
Whoa, whoa. A lot going on that play there. It looked like the man in motion took off
upfield before the ball was snapped. I was thinking the same thing.
I thought that was a penalty. But the referees didn't see it.
And the ball was fumbled behind the line of scrimmage, so third down is 16.
Yeah, well, behind the scrimmage. Yep, third down about 16, 17 yards. For Barnstable.
This is a big play right here.
Yes, it is.
Make some noise. Bounces outside.
There he goes. And finally, still going.
Wow.
On his feet. Wow. Is right.
They may go for it.
Yeah. They're inside Boxer territory.
They may go for it.
And that's... is not what the Boxer defense
wanted
to do.
Yeah, Boxers need to make a stop at about the 40-yard line.
Yeah, they don't want... Now they got 4th and 5. Timeout, Barnstable with 3:29 on the clock. So 3:29 on the clock. Both teams are talking to their coaches. This is a big defensive stop for another big defensive stop for the Boxers. They really need to keep Barnstable from getting a first down here.
This is when Tsunami comes into play.
Yeah. Well, the Red Hawks ground attack has really, they bought their A game tonight.
Yes, it is. Yes, they have.
Yeah, they've done an excellent job with the counter and then man in motion and then giving it to that running back going to the outside. Has really kept Brockton on its toes.
So let's see if they try and draw Brockton off sides.
Yeah.
That's what they're probably going to try and do. And
that's the second time, Brian. That's the second time. That's what Barnstable wanted to do, just like you said.
Draw them off sides, you know.
And the boxers could not contain themselves and just wait till the play developed.
Let the play – wait till that ball is hiked.
Yeah, that's a big mistake right
there. That's a huge mistake. Oh.
And that's going to be a first down. And that's a gift from Brockton to Barnstable. So we've got referees blow their whistle. I thought they were going to say timeout, but they're going to have a little meeting. That's number 34 right in the middle, Jordan.
Jordan's been running. Yeah, he's been hitting the holes and picking up big chunks of yards.
Big chunks of yardage.
All game long. He's probably got close to 100 yards.
And he's one of those running backs. He dishes out punishment, too. Solid individual. There he goes again. Finally stopped. Maybe a yard gain on the play. Maybe a couple yards on the play. So it's going to be third down and about 2 yards to go for a first down with 2 minutes and 47 seconds left in this third quarter. Barnstable has Brockton defense
we could use a loss
on their heels.
Yeah.
And the whistles blow.
Could use a loss on this play right here. Back them up. Back them up.
I'm not sure what.
They call timeout. Might have called timeout.
Usually timeouts is two hands. He just put one hand out there and pointed in the direction of Barnstable's. And, yeah, it's against Barnstable. I'm just not sure what the penalty was. But it helps Brock.
Illegal substitution.
Illegal substitution. It's called quarterback fake, and he faked the whole team.
Holding. Oh.
Touchdown. Barnstable.
18 got away with holding on 24.
He sure did.
Demetrius Sequoia.
Wow, what a play call there.
That was a good call.
Yeah, it was.
But
I think everybody was looking for Jordan to get the football, and the quarterback kept it. And basically ran in untouched. But Barnstable might have gotten away with the holding there. We won't know.
I know. I saw it.
It'd be nice to have the replay.
But they don't see everything. We don't see everything. Yeah. But I saw that. It was in the middle of the field right there.
Yeah, and the reason we don't have the replay is because the tech truck is down right now. And we apologize for the first half. There were some technical audio difficulties, and hopefully they've been ironed out. First game of the season.
Yes.
And our crack BCA sports team is doing the best they can to give you the best picture and audio possible.
That's right.
So the boxers are in a hole. With 2:25, they're down by 10 points, Brian.
But Brockton has done it before. They're just going to do it again.
So here we go.
Nice kick.
Yeah. Another deep kick taken at the five. Breaks a tackle, still on his feet. And finally taken down. And a nice run back, number 13.
Yeah, it was a nice run by
Josh 13. Stanley. You can see he waited for his blockers, and then he put the
burst.
Speed on.
Yeah.
His burst of speed, but nice job by Josh Stanley. Brockton offense comes back up on the field, and Brian, they really need to put something together here.
Yeah.
You know, just to keep the ball out of that ground attack that Barnstable has.
Yeah, those Red Hawks want to keep the ball out of their hands. Nice fake.
Nice job by the quarterback. Keeper. Jason Winodi with the carry. And that's going to be a penalty. I don't believe you can have two men in motion at the same time. So I'm sure that'll be the penalty. Illegal procedure.
Yep, legal shift.
And declined by Barnstable.
Second and 14.
Yep, 4-yard loss on the play.
All right, here we go. They're going to turn it up right now. Nice run.
Nice end around. Still going. Gets the first down. Number 13, Michael Victor with a nice carry. Nice job of running and going behind his blocks.
Yeah, he got around to the outside and just turned it upfield and was able to, you know, get down and get that first down.
1:18 on the clock here in the third quarter.
Shotgun.
Pat, intercepted! Intercepted! And he's going to take this to the house. Oh, let's see what they're going to call it. At the one?
They call it the one.
Wow. Wow. That was the first big mistake that Winodi has made today. I'm not sure if the receiver fell down or miscommunication on the where he was supposed to be, but I believe he fell down. And just
anyway, you look at it, he was out of position.
Yep. And tough break. And a big defensive play by the Red Hawks.
And does Brockton have a goal yard?
Stand.
Well, I tell you, goal line stand.
The way Barnstable have been running his football.
Yeah.
You know.
They've been just running
and
down.
And his first down, they got three chances to put this bad boy in the end zone.
Four,
yeah.
Oh, back him up.
And there's flags on the field.
Oh, the Ross, the head coach for Barnstable, is livid over there.
Oh, you know he is.
I'm trying to see. Ross Jacola.
So I believe there's a timeout with 51 seconds left in this third quarter.
Timeout possible.
And Henry Macnick has done a great job quarterbacking this Red Hawks team this evening. Again, he's a junior, number 12 for the Red Raiders, excuse me, the Red Hawks.
So what happened? There was a flag on the play and the ball wasn't moved?
The ball was never moved. And, and the coach for...
is livid.
Yeah, he's livid. One of the assistant coaches for Brockton is livid, and I don't blame him. Weren't there flags?
Yeah, there were flags on the field.
Yeah.
He wants an explanation.
Yeah, there was a couple flags out on the field. I don't know why nothing was done, but I don't blame Brockton's coaching staff to be upset. So the ball was not – flags are thrown. Ball was not moved. Straight ahead.
Nice stop.
Nice stop.
Nice stop.
So it'll be second down and goal.
The only thing that makes sense to me is they called timeout prior to
the flag
movement. And
what's up, Murph? How are you?
Oh God.
Yeah, so they drove in that time.
And they drive it in for a touchdown. Barnstable.
Touchdown, Barnstable.
With a 37-21 lead at the moment, with 15 seconds left in this third quarter.
Let's see if Brockton can turn it around.
They still got a whole quarter.
We know they have the capabilities.
We're going to have to do a check on the Red Hawks' running attack. Has been superb this evening. Kick is up, and the kick is good. So 38-21. The Boxers are in a hole.
And Brockton's in a hole.
Excuse me. Thank you. Brockton is in a hole, and Barnstable has the momentum right now. You can see it in the body language of their players.
Yes.
Skipping down the field.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, you have to feel good. You come into a hostile environment. First game of the season, and you've got a 17-point lead going into the fourth quarter.
And for years, Brockton has always been the team to beat.
Yeah.
You know?
Still is.
It still is. You know, you want to come to Brockton. Brockton has an amazing field. Our field is state-of-the-art. The program is awesome.
Yeah.
State-of-the-art. Nice kick.
Squib kick taken at the five. Breaks a tackle. Still going. And finally is tied up. A little traffic jam there, and he really had nowhere else to go. Brockton has decent field position, but now they're going to have to do something with the football.
Yeah. Yeah, they've had good field position almost all game.
Now in the position that they're in, down 38-21. 6 seconds left in this third quarter. They're going to have to basically score every time they touch the football.
Yes.
Their offense has the football. They're going to have to score some points.
And also stop.
And
Barnstable.
Stop Barnstable's running attack.
On some, you know. I think that was mine.
Hand off. To number 15.
And actually, he was tackled by Patrick O'Neill. Now, Patrick O'Neill's father was the defensive coordinator with Coach Peter Colombo for years. So, that's the backstory with O'Neill facing Brockton.
Okay, that was gain of 7 yards on the play. And they will switch sides as the third quarter has ended with Barnstable up 38-21. Going into the fourth quarter.
Yeah, 12 minutes is not a lot of time So they're going to have to score quickly and make stops, get the ball back to try and get back into this game.
Something here. Maybe referee to get back in the back, the back judge. And
nice,
there he goes.
Go.
Option.
Oh.
He gets the first down.
Nice tackle by number 6, Joel Labor.
Boxes with their hurry up offense. And taken down nicely by big number 74.
Yeah, he really had nowhere to go. It looked like there was a broken play there.
Well,
when he tried to hand it off.
Yeah, the number 74, he broke right through that offensive line. Maybe a missed blocking assignment, but
yeah,
that was too easy.
Aiden Canty.
Nice handoff right up the middle for about 8 yards on the carry.
And you know, when they get their running game going, they move quickly, but they just need to make stops when they're on defense.
Handoff again right up the middle, close to a first down. .10:46 on the clock and running. And it is a first down. Hand it off to the man in motion. That was Cameron Montero.
Yeah.
Oh, puts on the speed, breaks away. He's going to take it to the house, folks. No flags. Touchdown, Brockton, with 9:54 on the clock. Great job. It was a quarterback option.
Yes, and a 38-yard run. Once he broke through that hole and got to the open field, you're not catching him. So that's what Brockton needs to do. They need to continue to do things like that, make plays like that, score quickly, and now they need to turn up the defense and make some stops. Just under 10 minutes remaining in the game.
There's the kick, and the kick is good. So we got a two-possession game right now with 9:54 on the clock, Brian. And the key right now is Brockton has to stop Barnstable's running attack right away. They need the ball back. It's a two-possession game.
Yeah, yeah. They need to do a three and out.
Yes.
Or an interception or force a fumble.
Exactly.
They need something, but they need the ball in their hands.
Because with Barnstable's running attack, it's going to take time off the clock.
It's
so that's why, like you said, they need to get the defense needs to stop them three and out so they can get that offense back on the field. So again, 9:54 on the clock. The clock is not in the box's favor, but there's still enough time on there for them to make a dramatic comeback. They're only down by 10 points.
With 10 minutes remaining in the game.
10 minutes remaining in the ball game. Demetrius Sequia ready to kick off.
Short kick.
Yep. Whoa. Ball so taken down at about the 31 for Barnstable.
Yeah, so the Red Hawks have good field position. You know, inside or just outside the 30. This has been an exciting game.
Yes, it has. Nice way to kick off the fall season of high school basketball down here on the South Shore. Well, Barnstable's living up to their expectations. The sports paper said they're probably the best team down there in the Cape. And they're really showing it.
Yes, they are.
Nice job there by Tsunami and Company.
But the clock continues to tick. Because as long as they're staying on the ground, clock is running.
Ball's taken for a little nice gain of about 5 yards on the carry. Bring up third down and about 3 yards to go.
And if they're able to, if they're able to make a stop here, back them up a little bit, keep them from going for it.
And it's a first down. They could not stop the big, tough running back, number 34, who's done it all this evening.
All game long.
That was Eugene Jordan, who's been a thorn in Brockton's defense today. Little counter. And taken down, really what the boxers need, because they're really having a tough time with this running attack, is to get a turnover, like you said earlier.
Yeah, they need a turnover.
8 minutes, 33 seconds to go.
And the Red Hawks may not go to the air at all.
I can't even remember the last time it went to the air, maybe in the first quarter. A little pitch out. Oh, breaks a tackle. Another tackle.
Yeah. They could have held him to 2 yards.
Yeah. And instead he got six. Yeah, 5 or 6. It'll be third and short again. Again, no huddle offense for the Red Raiders. Excuse me, for the Red Hawks. Tight formation, handoff. He almost breaks away again, but he gets a first down again. This time, again, a number 34.
And I tell you, the Brockton defense, they have to be tired because they've been on the field a long time.
Yeah.
When Brockton scores, they score quickly. When Barnstable scores, except for those that trick play and stuff like that, they just are grinding.
Flag on the play.
Eating up clock and eating up yards.
And I tell you, the key to this offense is their offensive line. They've really stood tall.
Yes.
Up against this tough Brockton defense, and they've made holes and openings for these running backs to get through and get chunks of yardage.
And they have been getting chunks of yards. All right, they got backed up there. So now it's first and 15.
Little counter fake. Quarterback has it, rolls out of the pocket, throws it deep.
Yes.
And they're going to call pass interference.
And it should be pass interference on the offense.
Yeah, good eyes right there. If it, let's see what they're going to call.
Because the defender had position to make the interception.
And the receiver made the initial contact, it looked like, from up here.
Yeah, and he's telling the coach on that side. So let's see which way it goes.
Oh, Oh, they're calling it on the defense.
Well, I'm a little biased.
Yeah.
But
it was a tough call. It could have went either way.
It could have went either way.
But the defender, they're going to have to be a little bit more aware back there of getting that, turning that head around a little bit earlier to make sure, see where the football is.
Well, he was in position to catch the ball and was trying to come back to it when the offensive guy pulled him back.
7:21 on the clock. Barnstable marching down the field. Running back breaks the tackle, cuts back in the middle, and gets the first down again. Again, just great running, and it's starting to wear down the Brockton defense.
Yeah, Brockton's tired.
Yeah, I mean.
Understandably so.
Yeah, I mean, 95% of the Barnstable offense is running. They're running attack.
Yep. Season opener at home, and the gameplay is a lot different than practice.
Yeah. And I tell you, one thing about this Barnstable team, loaded with seniors.
Yeah.
So right now you got a Barnstable team that's very experienced going up against a Brockton team that's not
fairly
quite
young.
Fairly new, not quite quite as experienced. They lost a lot of seniors last year. Not making excuses, but that makes a big difference.
But I tell you what, I'll put my Brockton boxes up against anybody. Hmm. And,
you know,
they're not going to go undefeated, but they're also not going to go 0-4.
Right, and they should be in most ball games this year.
I mean, because when you look at the talent they have on the field, with Jason Winati, Cameron Montero, Malachi McLean, my boy, Tsunami Resende, Xavier Laguerre, you know, it goes on and on and on. All of you guys are doing a great job. Just going to have to do better next week.
Okay, third down, about 10 yards to go. A little counter. And he's taken down inside the 15 by number 20. So you know they're going to go for it. It'll be fourth down and about 4 yards to go. And there's no reason why Barnstable should not go for it or maybe even kick a field goal.
Yes.
Fourth
down and
four. Yep. Actually, this might be the time to just to practice field goal kicking. I mean, you got a 10-point lead. There's 5 minutes and 26 seconds left in this ball game. But maybe the coach for Barnstable is going in for the kill.
Yeah.
And it'll be a timeout, Barnstable. So timeout with 5:15 on the clock.
They should,
in the fourth quarter.
They should go with the field goal because, you know, their kicker made a field goal from that range earlier in the game. So.
We'll see what happens.
And you know what, Miles? In all the years we commentated, kicking has not always been a staple with high school football. They just wouldn't kick. They would just go for 2-point conversions, and even instead of going for an extra point, because they didn't have any kickers. But you know, both teams. The kickers have made every kick that they've needed to make, whether it was an extra point or whether it was a field goal. They've kicked well. And with distance.
Yeah, actually, this is one of the better football games as far as kickers go, making their extra points and their field goal attempts. Everybody's been pretty much on the money. So here we go. Fourth down. Red Hawks are going for it. They feel good about it. They've got a 10-point lead, and there's only 5 minutes and 15 seconds left in this football game. Man in motion, counter, right up the middle, open, first down, and a little bit more. Inside the 5-yard line goes the Red Hawks.
Yeah, inside the 3.
And they're not wasting no time. with this no-huddle offense, they're not giving the boxers a chance to catch their breath. Just constant right in there. An untouched touchdown by Eugene Jordan. I mean, the hole was wide open. And like you said, this boxer team, they're spent.
Yeah.
Out there, they're spent.
Yeah, they're tired. And rightfully so. Yeah. I mean, but they have nothing to hold their heads low on. The game is closer than the score represents.
Yep. Right now, 44-28. Kick is up and good. 45-28 with 4 minutes and 58 seconds left. This experienced Barnstable team really came out here and showed that they are an experienced, senior-laden, talented team coming out of Cape Cod.
And Brockton was playing catch-up for most of the game.
Yeah.
You know, they were playing from behind. They were able to go into the half leading by three. And, you know, and then Barnstable just turned it up in the third quarter and continued to carry their momentum.
Buzzed. Good example, just like a boxing match. Our guy looks pretty good in those first few rounds, but all of a sudden the opponent starts really giving them body shots, and over time it just takes its toll.
Yes.
As the rounds go on. Long kick. This is a good kicker for the Red Hawks, as most of his kicks have been deep. The return man, number 20.
Malik Johnson.
Yep, Malik Johnson. And there's a Red Hawk down, I believe, over there on the sideline who made the tackle. So there'll be an official timeout. With 4 minutes, 49 seconds left in this football game. He's not moving. Oh, here we go. Saw his head move.
Yeah, it's tough when you see a high school kid go down. You know, you always get nervous.
Yeah.
You know, how serious is the injury?
Yeah.
When I was down on the field collecting information about the kids that are playing, would be starting, there was a young man that had a cast on. He's down there. He's right at the 45-yard line.
Uh-huh.
And he's got a full cast on his left leg from his thigh all the way down. And I was teasing him. I said, if you didn't want to play today, you could have just told the coach you didn't want to play. So he laughed, and one of his teammates laughed. But, you know, it's tough for these kids. These kids give their all. They give their all. Win, lose, or draw, they give their all, you know. Players like Tsunami out there just battling play after play, as well as everybody that's got to touch the ball or got on the field, make some contact.
Okay, first and 10, little pitch out to the flat. Cuts back up the field and finally taken out of bounds, number 15. That was Powell with the catch and carry.
And the boxers are going hurry up.
Three wideouts at the top of your screen. Still on his feet. Powell trying to make something happen. That'll make a second down and about 3 yards to go for a first.
Yeah, and they're just trying to cut into this lead. You know, the likelihood of them coming back is slim.
4:13 on the clock.
Yeah, with the time remaining. Stops the
he
clock.
Chased out of bounds at around the 50 or inside the 50 in Red Hawk territory. 4:02 with the clock stopping. Long pass, way out there. Oh! For a second there, I thought he was going to get under it, but.
Yeah, he stretched out. He put it all
on the line.
His whole body Cameron
out
Montero.
There. Nice job, Cameron, trying to get that football.
It looks like he might have jammed his shoulder because I see him out there, you know, rolling his arm around.
Unodi, he's got the play.
It's a keeper.
Quarterback option. And he's taken down about 5 yards short of the first down. 3 minutes, 38 seconds left to go in this ball game.
Threw it high, but looks like he got the first down.
Yeah, he's very close.
Stretched out.
Depends on where they're going to mark it. And they give
him
a terrible
spot. Oh, they marked it short. That's a bad spot.
Yeah, that was a terrible spot.
He was further than that.
Wow. So it makes it fourth down in inches, maybe a foot.
Quarterback keeper. Nope.
Gives it straight up the middle.
Nice.
To Barnes. Barnes gets the first down with 2 minutes and 51 seconds left in this football game. Snap.
He's going for it.
Nody throwing it long, deep. Got him.
Touchdown.
Touchdown. Boxes on a strike. On a 38-yard strike to the wide receiver out there.
Yeah, I saw that.
Nice. Nice play.
Yeah, I saw that all the way. I mean, the receiver was in position, and it was a perfect throw. Hit him right in the breadbasket. Easy peasy.
Yeah, he aired that out very nicely.
Yes.
Unodi. So here's the extra point. It's right now it's 45-34 with 2:36 left on the clock. Snap. Kick is up. Kick
almost
is
blocked.
Good.
Kick is good.
So the box is only down by 10 with 2 minutes, 36 seconds left in this football game. It just goes to show you this Brockton High young Brockton High football team has no quit.
No quit. So now, I'm going to go for an onside kick.
I would, with 2 minutes.
Yeah.
36 seconds on the clock.
They haven't been able to stop the running game since the first half. So, why not? Love the way these kids hustle in and on and off the field.
Didn't mean to have the flash on.
Looks better though. Yeah. Always flash everything.
So the boxes will kick off. It is annoying, but it's not going to go long enough, far enough. It had to go at least to the 50.
Yeah.
So the Red Hawks will take possession
take possession.
2 minutes and 36 seconds left. So first and 10 inside Brockton territory. Little counter right up the middle.
And if they're able to, well, no, because the clock's going to run out before only shot they have to get the ball back is to
take it away.
Take it away.
Yeah. On this play.
Because three plays and this game's over.
Whoa, breaks a tackle. He should have been in the backfield. Taken down in the backfield. It's just missed tackle there. Makes it third down and about 3 yards to go.
Just over a minute 30 remaining in the game. And I want to acknowledge the BCA staff for all they do in bringing you this exciting first game of the season. Kudos to you guys. Great job.
Big opening. There he goes.
Emma over there voguing.
Touchdown, Barnstable.
Oh, no. I turned my head for a second.
Aiden Edwards with the end around and just shows his speed.
Yeah.
And they get a quick score with 1 minute and 14 seconds left in this ball game. Put salt on the wound.
That's unfortunate because, you know, the Brockton Boxers were able to get it back to 10 points, respectable, difference. Differential and
I think one problem is, Brian, and we brought this up before, defense is spent.
They're spent.
You know, they've been out there a lot.
Yeah.
Tonight, a lot.
And they just beat them down. And they have.
Again, you have a very experienced, senior-laden Barnstable team going up against a young Brockton team, and Brockton did pretty good on their first game of the season, trying to get familiar with themselves, and they have nothing to be hang their heads for.
No.
They scored some points. They got 35 points.
Outside of the score is the only negative thing right here. But it was an outstanding game.
Yeah, a lot of action.
Exciting. Great plays on both sides of the field, offensively and defensively. But unfortunately, you know, the common – oh, there we go.
Nice job by the returner.
Yeah, but the common narrative is that the Barnstable – Red Hawks really just, kept the ground game so intact. They just continue to pound, pick up chunks of yards, move the sticks, and just beat up on the Boxers' defense.
Yeah, it just took its toll on Brockton's defense tonight.
So... But it was an entertaining game.
Very
all the way around.
Winodi out of the pocket, passes, gets it to number 12, and he gets a first down. with less than a minute to go in this football game.
But I'll tell you, they may be young, but their versatility is really, really good. As they play and connect more and more and are able to cut back on some of the mistakes, they'll be formidable.
And Munodi's taken down after about a yard game. He was looking to throw it deep, but it was good coverage.
And you know what? It shows his intelligence there, his football intelligence, not to just throw it up there into coverage.
Once again, we please ask if you check your belongings and make sure that you take your trash with you as you exit the stadium towards Brockton High School. The Forest Ave entrance is closed.
Long pass out there in the flat. It's good at about the 40-yard line with no time left. That's it, folks. Brockton in their home opener goes down to a very good Barnstable team in a very exciting football game, 52-35. And, Brian, your thoughts?
My thoughts are, despite the score, it was a fun game to watch, a fun game to call. I see all the good and the potential with the Brockton High football team, and I think they'll do well this season. You can't win them all, and the first one got away from them. But Barnstable played well. Kudos to them. Their running game is formidable.
And what'd you think, real quickly, of Munodi? His play for, as a starting quarterback this year.
Well, Nadi did a great job. He really was good. He showed his versatility as far as ability to run. You know, he ran that 80-yard touchdown. And his accuracy when he throws is pretty good. It's really good. He hit the post pattern down in the corner. And you really have to trust your receivers when you throw laterals. They threw a couple of laterals, and the receivers caught the ball and was able to pick up yards. Because if you don't catch the ball on the lateral, that's a live ball.
Yeah. Well, there you have it, folks. Brockton's home opener. A little downer, but saw a lot of good things. Barnstable comes out of here with a win, 52-35. I'm Miles Jackson along with Brian Madden. We'll see you at the next ball game, folks.
Good night.